AudioThings Speakers is the follow-up to their speaker plugin. It's not just a speaker emulation plugin, but it does so much more. It's more in-depth than you would expect at first. I'll show you all of that in this video. I'm Marlon and this is the White Noise Studio. Before we start, please subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so you won't miss out on any new video. The main part of the plugin is globally divided into two parts. The left is microphones and the right is speakers. There is some overlap in the impulse models, more on that later. Below here are effects like distortion, compressor, filter and background noise. Background noise in itself is already a separate module which could have been as important as speakers and microphones, and again, more on that later. Both the microphones module and speakers module share the same controls. Pitch for changing the pitch of the impulse. Echo, which is how much you delay the impulse. Feedback is how often the echo is repeated. A stereo balance, so a left-right panning knob. And a mix knob to set how much the module blends in. And if you press this edit button, you will go into the EQ settings for this module only. It's a 5-band EQ and features low and high shelf and global band EQs. Not much to tweak, but more than enough to sculpt the impulse. So the microphone part and speakers part share the exact same controls as you can see. Here are all 30 models for the microphones. And here are all 47 models for the speakers. There are 38 background noises. These background noises generate sounds by themselves, so there is no input needed. You can also import your own background sounds. And even cooler is the following: all elements can be configured freely. And you do that by using this matrix here. I want the noise here, the compressor here. You can even decide where the input will go. You can bypass or enable every module by doing Ctrl click. This makes the routing very flexible and opens up a world of possibilities. For instance, I take a background noise like a broken radio. Then I want it to sound old, so I pick the S510C MIG impulse. And it would be cool to add a delay with an amp sound for more texture. I pick Davori and turn up the echo and dial down the mix. And I enable the filter. Now by itself, it's already creating a vibe, and let's play this track. I lower the input gain and add distortion or degradation behind the input. Let's choose one of the many degradation distortion types and go for Robotics, which works by changing the fast Fourier transform amount. This by itself is a very vibey soundscape. This can be of such great value in post-production when doing mixes for film or TV. And it's included in this plugin. And if you add your own waveform to the background, all possibilities will truly get unlimited. Okay, so, but how do the impulses actually sound? Since this plugin is called Speakers, I can say the impulses sound excellent and have vibe. How useful they are depends, of course, on which input you use. Let's quickly go over some of the speaker models. In mixing, you always get a question to have something sound like a radio. So by picking one of these impulses, you quickly get it done. Some impulses seem a bit bass heavy for what it represents, but you can easily fix that by rolling off some low end with the EQ. And here are the impulses for the microphones. My issue with this is that, more so than with speakers, microphone impulses and the end result depend heavily on the source. If you have a heavy coloring mic like the SM57 and you apply the SM57, it will not sound like an SM57. So ideally, you need a as clean as possible microphone as your source. Something which Slit VMS has, a clean source microphone to add a microphone flavor. I have an overhead track here, which was recorded with a Neumann TLM-103. Great mic, a bit of high boost. Let's go over the impulses. As you can hear, some are a hit and some are a miss. But all of them add vibe. You instantly get a vibe from them, which I like. Okay, bass drum. They have a subkick impulse. Let's check it out. It does add a subkick vibe. And with this pitch dial, you can do something nice. If you, for instance, have a bass drum with a lot of sublows and attack, but lack some thud, do this. Add an impulse like the subkick. Turn up the pitch until it's an octave higher and dial that in. Right in the 80 to 120 Hz area, which will give you a thud, without EQing and boosting all sorts of mud. Now you have added some harmonics and frequencies one octave above the lowest fundamental. You can also use it to add an octave under a snare, for instance, where you downpitch the impulse. Let me show you. Works with every source. Now let me use the microphone impulses on a synth. I can say that on this synth, all of these impulses are sounding great. If they fit the track is a different question, but without exception, they are very usable and add that vibe I mentioned before. I play more with this synth and the plugin. very versatile. So speakers by AudioThing, it does speakers and microphone emulation and works as a dual delay and has great distortions. It can work as a fattener and pitch shifter and as an instant vibe creator and as a sound design tool and as an atmosphere creator. AudioThing shouldn't have named this plugin speakers, but awesome. If you want to know more versatile plugins, watch the videos now displayed on screen. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!